Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So, this video I'm going to teach you how to install Los Santos Police Department mod into your GTA 5. This mod allows you to basically roll, like basically play as a police officer at the city of Los Santos. So, if you follow this guy, I trust you. Trust me, you will be able to download this. Alright, so first you're going to click on download this file right here. Accept the term agreement. And then click on this one here, and you can do manual install if you want to, but I prefer just do it, just click on this thing and like it's set up basically everything for you automated. So while we're at that, we're gonna, alright, it said thank you for downloading your LSPD for first respond. Then it should pop down here soon. Alright, so now, so while we're waiting for this, I'm gonna tell you guys about a new thing. I'm gonna record a new video for this game that I've been playing. It's called, let me check for you. Yeah, it's called A Cycle. It's one of the good games that I play. And also, I would probably, but Cycle would probably do GTA 5 story mode. It could be some Minecraft, some Rust, toss in there, you know, just a variety of game that I play. So, I'm still gonna be like a channel where I provide like, you know, helping with like, you know, installing stuff, but I will try and do that. Another game I will probably up is called 911 Operator. That, send it back, that's gonna be my next video on that. So, you click on that thing, you should see the screen. Please tell me how the setup's loading. Wake up, select a language, select your language. That's English, French, German. Welcome to LSPD Sub Guy. Click next. I agree. Yeah, LSPD and remove LSPD FR 2.3. If this is, click on this if you have like the old thing, old version of it. If you don't, you don't have to. Click on this folder. Let it install. So while this thing is installed, you're gonna just now wait, probably take like really quick. Shouldn't be that long. Okay, shortcut of a folder. Alright, when it's finished, and you click on it, it will launch the first time configurator. Where it will basically tell you what will happen. So I have also another announcement. I've been working with this server, it's called Server in War for Military Roleplay Server for Garry's Mod. It's a project I've been working really hard on. I'll be a commander for one of these, for one of the brand. So you want to join me? That will come up ASAP as an update. So you click next on this. You have bridge booking comes up. Please accept. Show license. When I show license, it should pop up a window. When you will like here, you will make you have to wait this, and you accept. Then it should. Yep, it will check mark. Just open a little startup. Do it for me. And it's been installed successfully. And if there's anything more, and if there's like two more categories now, just follow step. You should be fine. So now, next, after this, is now that I've been launched successfully, all you have to do is go to your. Explorer. This is personally for me for default. Your folder could be anywhere, so I would recommend trying to find it out. So you will click on this PC, OS, program file, Rockstar game. No, I'm sorry, not x86. It's on just normal program file, and it should be Rockstar game, GTA 5, and down here. It would be successfully installed, and then all you need to do is launch Rage Plug and Hook, this shortcut right here. Click yes, and I already have this installed, so it will, like, I think it will pop up just, it will go immediately for me. But, however, if this is, however, I will try to get done. So, if this is not your first time installing, you just see the screen, it will pop up in the middle of your monitor. Then you would launch a game. However, after install the first time up, it should give you like a big screen like Rage Quit display all the setting for you. Let's see if it launch it. Yep, right here. There, you should know that. There, press OK. Alright, initialize the shortcut for you. And we just wait until it finish loading in. Alright, so now click on this, and then you see plugin. I have another plugin called Cop Holster, which is like your holster, like the animation with holster. However, you should LPFFRS one. You see all these plugins on startup. Check mark it, save and launch. And then once you save it and launch it, it will launch your game with the plugin hook. However, remember this, you cannot go online with this thing installed. So you want to go, you have to close your game and basically launch it normally. So, save and launch, it should launch it up in game. You shouldn't have to do anything else, by the way. When you go in game already, here, I will do it for you. Save and launch, okay. And then if you want to open up the menu setting again, just hold shift while you launch. And when you go in game, you just have to take like my character car, drive it to the police station, and then you press E, like, you know, go on duty, change your clothes, your car, everything. Yeah, that's it. And that's how you install SpeedFR. I will like do it for you guys once so you guys can see exactly on screen like what will happen. Oh, a tip. So, if you guys go on Steam and you have it like save in Steam, or yeah, you just have it like on Steam. Let me see. Yeah, you can press right click it, property. And then, if you own the game on Steam, by the way, if this is not like once like you implement it in the shortcut, if you have it on Steam, if you see a file here called local file, and you can click like browse local file, and it will take you directly to the GTA 5 folder. But that is only if you have Steam. As you can see, I don't have a Steam version. I forgot it into Steam. I don't have an option that I own the game on Search Club. Right. So, Rockstar symbol. I would not cut this at all. And to like show you guys exactly what you're gonna do. So, this will launch first. And then alright, this will launch, loading, so, and then like, just like for a time thing, like, it'll be there, you'll be fine, you're not being hacked. It's loading to story mode for you right now. So yeah. You see in the main screen, it like it shows you the exact step. Like what step is that right now? Ooh. Okay. 7 p.m. Yeah. So. See, it's loading. Plug it up right now. So, if you got interested in military roleplay, you have access to Garry's mod. I will be launching a server with Sovereign War once again. If you want to, you can check it out by I believe in the description. And I will give you alright, and if this video reaches 5 likes, I will post an update to the Sovereign War MRP that I've been working for. However, this, I will not disclose any confidential information. I will just, you know, go with what is public. There you go. So now, this I have some few more mods. So you say in the lab, you see it's mod. All right. Waiting for plugin. So it will. I would select an option where it will unload and will load back up. All right. All right. So once you load up, you will go to the police department right here. Like for example, this is one of the police department. You will go to it. And then press E to enter. And then it will take you to this screen, which will allow you to go on duty and become a police officer. Here you go on duty. Click on that. And now you're officially on duty. You can now, you see on the left side a few more calls. That's why I got that. But then you can click on police locker. And you'll switch between different division. There's IAAA. This DOA, SAPR, LSPD, that's one of the best one. You can switch between the rank as well, so there's detective, senior officer, officer 3, officer, and random infantry. You can switch between patrol stun, patrol, and just and SWAT. Advanced customization, you can have different thing. Class. Earring. Watch. Yeah. And so that's how you install LSPDFR. Thank you for watching. Leave a like, subscribe, and comment down below. And share it if you found this video helpful. Thank you. And we're going to see you in the next video.